Hey, Shirley County, this is Shirley County Cop Watch, and we are back on the Collier County Sheriff propaganda machine. Oh my God. You saw I've got multiple videos on here what they've been doing this guy. This is insane. The guy's a constitutionalist. All he does is stand up for his rights. There's nothing wrong with that. And, you know, I just did a video, you know, the night that we heard that they beat this guy again. So the quick story is, this guy right here, 2 years ago, he stood up for his rights, did nothing wrong. Seven Collier County sheriffs beat him so bad he was in the hospital for days. When the head sheriff saw it, they dropped all charges because he didn't do anything wrong. And now he's got a federal lawsuit on Collier County Sheriff, they've been found. It's so bad that this guy had to get cameras in his car, those little car DVR cameras, because they've been following him ever since. As you know, in most other places, when you get a lawsuit against a place, usually the sheriff or the police will say, back off, you know, this is not going to look good if you keep messing with them. That's not what happened. It is unbelievable. When the whole story comes out, you guys are going to freak how freaking corrupt it is here in Collier County. With the Collier County Sheriff. I mean, the documentation of how many times they've pulled him over and did this and that just because he's freaking trying to file a lawsuit, a totally just lawsuit. I'm going to attach the video of the beating, the first one, to this video, but now we got the propaganda machine, so they finally pulled him over again, like I said, multiple times since the beating a couple of years ago. And, the other reason why they hate this guy, too, is because he found an awesome freaking lawyer that is not from here, so she's not in the corrupt system here, and that's why they hate it. They can't control her, and they know she's the real freaking deal, period. So they are freaking out. So this time, their propaganda machine is going that Robert Harris, I personally know him, met him, we're Facebook friends, everything. We've ate dinner. The guy is a constitutionalist. That's it. He wouldn't freaking hurt anybody. So now the new scam is they pulled him over again since the first beating that was unrealistic. And they're saying that he attacked the deputy. What? This is the biggest freaking BS scam. Just mind-blowing. Mind-blowing. So we're going to be keeping on top of this, investigating it. We got other people that are investigating it. This is sick, man. This is disgusting sick. So, I mean, they instantly, got it out to Wink News. They did, that he attacked him, which is bull crap. They instantly got it out to NBC News, you know, that Good Samaritan. And that's what was really messed up, too. That's why we think this is total freaking BS scam setup. Because they also, too, that a Good Samaritan, while driving by, saw the altercation and called it in. What a bunch of crap. Really? Let's start investigating who this Good Samaritan is. And, so much to investigate yet, but I just want to let you guys know what's going on. The propaganda machine is big. You know places that are so corrupt, that's what they do. If you sue them, they want to they did it to the dog guy here. In Punta Gorda, Florida, the guy that was ate by the dog for no light on his bicycle with the Punta Gorda police, Lee Cole, after that happened, the Punta Gorda police didn't do anything, but we live in a county called Charlotte County, so Punta Gorda police live inside there. Punta Gorda police didn't do anything because they're a little bit smarter than Collier County, but they had Charlotte County Sheriff following the guy around constantly popping. I mean, the guy was unfortunately addicted to drugs, so they got him for... they got him on that, and then the lawyers said, you know, well, they forced a hand because they had all these other charges on him, and they freaking pleaded all the way the lawsuit, whereas she would have got millions for what they did to him. It was insane. Got it down to 75 grand. Didn't even include the medical bills. The dog ate him so bad, the medical bills were $130,000. Didn't even include that. So that is how corrupt it is in South of Florida. Say a prayer if anybody's got lawyers that they can send their way, ACLU, FBI, whatever, we don't care. It is disgusting corrupt, and as you know, that's why I started a Charlotte County Cop Watch 3 years ago, because it happened to me, Charlotte County. Ken Hill, Did perjury in court, got the case thrown out against our stalker, and Bill Pramell, the sheriff, knew about it, so did internal investigations, and they did nothing. This is just unbelievable. That's why I started Cop Watch and Live Free or Die People. YouTube channel's now at 43 million, almost ready to hit 44 million, 41,000 subscribers, because people are sick of it.
New tonight, he's accused of attacking a Collier County deputy. His family says Robert Harris was set up. A good Samaritan witnessed the whole thing today and called 911. Good evening, I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Lisa Spooner. Well, now Harris's family is backtracking, saying deputies beat him up first, and it was all caught on dash cam video. NBC2's Graham Hunter has been digging for answers all day. He's live in Naples tonight.
Well, Harris's brother, Bo, tells me that Robert was involved in a similar incident back in 2014 that ended with him being beat up by deputies. And now, this latest incident today, right here near Palm Springs Boulevard and Radio Road.
You could hear the chopper come over.
Early Friday morning.
And there was all kinds of police cars, undercover cops up on the street.
All for Robert Harris. He was pulled over.
It's really a quiet neighborhood.
The Collier County Sheriff's Office says he tried to pull a deputy into his car.
And it's unusual.
The deputy tried to tase Harris, but Harris took the taser.
I'm just thrilled that someone, a passerby, a Good Samaritan, tried to help the cop.
The Good Samaritan called 911 and backup came to help. The deputy suffered minor injuries and Harris went to the hospital.
The cops are retaliating.
That's Bo Harris, Robert's older brother. He says it all happened before, back in 2014.
He spent a week in a hospital last time they beat him up.
Bo says this is video of the incident. You can hear an altercation.
Turn over! I can't!
And then see deputies hitting someone. Bo says it's Robert with batons.
Every time this man gets pulled over, he's been beat twice. I'm talking about bad.
Harris faced six charges, but all the charges were dropped. Bo believes today's incident is retaliation for a lawsuit Harris is trying to file over the previous altercation.
Deputies say that he actually pulled the deputy into his car. Does that sound like something he
no,
would do?
No, I'm telling you, my brother is not a violent man at all.
Collier County Sheriff Kevin Rambosk passed along his thanks to that Good Samaritan for stopping to help his deputy earlier today. Meanwhile, Harris spent part of his day in the hospital. He was released and booked into jail earlier tonight. Reporting live in Collier County, Graham Hunter, NBC2.
New developments tonight. Investigators say when a deputy pulled this driver over, he pulled that deputy into his car and started assaulting him. That's when the sheriff's office says a Good Samaritan stepped in, potentially saving that deputy's life. But all new tonight, that suspect's family says that's not how it happened. Let's start now with the Night Beat's Christina Lusby live at the Collier County Sheriff's Office in Naples with that story. Christina.
We spoke with the man's family, and his brother tells us that his brother was targeted because he had ongoing issues with the sheriff's office. A deputy pulled inside a car.
He's fighting him.
After a routine traffic stop on Palm Springs Boulevard in East Naples.
And it looks like the police officer is having some trouble getting the guy out of the car.
Reports show the struggle caught the attention of a Good Samaritan who helped stop the fight.
They need as much help as they can get.
Investigators say 41-year-old Robert Harris was the man fighting the deputy.
I am so glad somebody stepped in. Truthfully, that's the best thing of all. That, you know, it's today I am big on our blue.
Harris's family says he's mentally slow and was a target of the sheriff's department.
My brother is a gentle giant. I'm saying he ain't never hurt nobody. He's always out to help somebody. That's not my brother. And like I said, it all boils back down to the lawsuit he's got against the county.
Harris has filed a notice of intent to sue the department after this incident in 2013.
Hey, I step it up.
You can see an officer on the ground to the left and Harris on the ground to the right. He was arrested and arrested again tonight after reports show his fight with the deputy left them both with minor injuries.
I think he needs help.
And Harris was taken to the hospital, and when he's released, he'll be formally charged. Live on the Night Beat, Christina Lusby, Wink News, now.
Robert, here's the thing. Do you work in here?
I am working for Randy, thank you.
Okay, do you work inside this place?
Yeah, for today.
Is there anybody that can confirm that? Because you're coming out of a closed place. That's what the problem is.
Listen, he just let me out.
Okay, is he back there?
Yeah, he's still back there with the generator running.
Relax, okay? I have a job I have to do. You understand that? Okay, there's burglaries in these things all the time. I see you come out with a bicycle, with a backpack, okay, at 9:30 at night.
I always wear a backpack, sir. You always know this.
Okay, and did I know you before I pulled you over? No. Okay, you're being very abrasive right now. What makes me think that you were back there doing something wrong? Do you understand that?
I would like to have a supervisor.
Well, too bad. That's not going to happen.
Are you denying my
right? Yes, I am, because you don't have a right to a supervisor. If you call 911, I am going to take you to jail for abuse of 911.
Why? Because you are not...
Because you're not... It's not an emergency.
I have the right to talk to your superiors.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't. Did you get his ID yet?
It's Robert Price, I think, is his last name.
No,
Robert
it's
something.
Not. Let me see your ID. Just talk to 2008. I don't give a shit about 2008. Let me see your ID. I'm going...
He was coming out of here. Everything's closed.
You guys are harassing me. You know.
Let me see your ID, man.
I have no ID.
Which storage unit is this guy in?
Why don't you just go right at the fountain? You know Rock and Roll Randy.
What about him?
That's who I'm working for, thank you.
He owns a place back there? Because last time I checked, he was homeless.
What's your name, man? Robert. Robert what? Robert what?
I'm the phone. I'm the phone. Thank you.
Corporal.
Hey, Randy, come out to the gate and talk to these officers, please. Thank you.
What's your last name, Robert?
Of the family in Harris. And I do not consent.
Is it Harris? H-A-R-R-I-S?
Sir, you do realize I have a valid reason to get your ID. You failing to produce your ID, we'll land you in jail. Do you understand that? Or if you fail to identify yourself.
No, I just don't like being harassed. That's
all. Harassed. I'm trying to get your name and date of birth, man.
Over there you have harassed me.
Look, what is your name?
Have I committed a crime, sir?
I am investigating a loitering and prowling complaint, yes.
From who? I have the right to face my accuser, sir.
Well, you're facing
him. Are you taking your wages under false pretenses, sir?
Step off the bike. Step off the bike.
I don't consent. Ow. I have not done nothing.
Roll over.
I have not done nothing.
Turn around. Turn around.
I have not done nothing.
I'm gonna
turn around. I do not consent.
Turn around. Turn around.
I want your supervisor.
Watch out. Roll it out! Do it all, go and taser! Roll over!
Do it!
Turn over! I want you supervisor!
I have not done nothing. I want your supervisor.
I'm going to tase you again. Better roll over.
I can't. He's on me, dude.
No one's on you. Roll over.
Okay, okay. Let me take my fucking bag off.
Roll the fuck over.
I will. I have not done nothing. Harassment. Stalking. I want the supervisor.
Morgan Mason, you don't roll over.
I have not done nothing, sir.
Dude, turn over. What's wrong with you?
I have not done nothing.
Stop fighting and just turn
I'm
over.
I'm not fighting.
Don't you grab me like that again.
I'm not
it,
grabbing you. I have not done nothing.
Nothing, boss. I did not do nothing.
All right, I got one.
I didn't even do nothing.
Tappy, hey, grab him. Grab him.
I can't fucking breathe.
Got canine here if you need him.
You fucking
him.
I didn't even fucking.
Give me that dog. Get out of the way.
I didn't even do nothing.
Get off his leg. Get off his legs, dude. Get off his leg.
Watch out.
Watch out. Watch out. Get off.
Whoa, wait. He's on.
I got him. Good. Oh, I can't even fucking breathe.
Shut up.
I can't breathe this.
Get the hood out.
Where's this gentleman right here?
Oh, he's a ride-along.
Then he needs to fix the car. So I'll fix the car, please.
Who's ride-along?
Who's ride-along, you say? He stays in the fucking car.
Yeah. I didn't even do
fuck,
nothing.
Who's is he? Who's is he?
He's mine.
I didn't even do nothing. I can't even fucking breathe.
Somebody take care of him.
I can't even fucking breathe.
What do we need EMS for? Hey, we just got the one?
I guess so. I think so.
Just the one? Wingo?
Yeah, just.
There we go.
EMS just came.
Do you need an ambulance? Dude.
He can't breathe. Undo his head. Get his vest off.
I
can't breathe.
Roll to your side.
He's probably
right there. That's fine. He can just sit on his side.
No, we're good.
I just can't record you. The strap is broken. It won't shut.
The
exit gate.
Yeah.
I know they're tied up. If you get any priority calls, go ahead and dispatch me out.
Tampa Street, Charlie 20 in units, on toll gate 1015.
Bravo 20, 861. Bravo 20, Bravo 861. Go ahead, sir. Can I have your last four, please? 4584, 4584.
Call off to be anonymous, but want something done about it.
All right, next bill.